G'day legends, we're back today. First off-road day on the Keyo, the 890 Adventure R. It's been a long time coming, last month or so after the accident's been a little bit drawn out, you could say. She is looking fine. Done what we need to do, got the GPS mounted up there. KTM bash plates all sorted out. The Acabus handguards, massive thanks to KTM at Newcastle for getting all of that sorted out for me. Absolutely stoked. And of course today, for the first time in real anger, we're using the Nexx Wed 3, the Keyo Carbon. So today's a big day. First, hanging out just to get out, have a bit of fun. Then you got throttle riding adventures here. Mark's chilling out. How's your day going, mate? You're having a day. I've dropped my Action 4 on the road. You're not logged into your drone, but it's only going to get better, isn't it?
This is so annoying, isn't it?
Technology's only good when it's working. So we're going to get on the road. Guys, sit back, relax. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. It is free. Like the video and share it. Let's get out there and have some fun. So legends, we're back. It's great to be back on the bike. We're heading out for our first run on the dirt today. Literally picked up the 890 yesterday and did a few bits and pieces to it just to get it right. We're heading out and we're going to get comfortable. Kicking off just out of Karua, we're going to head out to Branch Lane and then up around the back of Westmantles and Moncaroy. We're going to go do a bit of Dungog and Stroud and just those really nice dirt areas around the area. So it should be really good. I'm actually quite keen to get out and about and get back into the dirt, really. First run on the dirt after the accident. So, you know, a little bit dubious, but we'll just see how it all goes. Sporting some new gear, the Nexx Wed 3, which I'm absolutely loving. I've been using this in some of the test rides. And my first impression so far, even though it's a heavier helmet than most that you'll see out there, it actually, you don't feel the weight. I'd love the action camera mounts that come with the helmet. The visor down below, like the sun shield, is just fantastic as well. So yeah, first impressions, love it. Very, very comfortable. The ventilation is amazing. So we're going to talk about the helmet a little bit more. We're going to talk a lot about the bike, a lot about getting out, maybe a little bit about the accident. We're just going to get out and have some fun. It's an outstanding day. I couldn't pick a better day than this. So yeah, and here we go. We're on the gravel. So let's get into it. At the moment, the front feels really sketchy in a lot of this loose stuff. So it's just moving around a fair bit. And then we're onto the hard pack dirt now as well. Tell you what though, it's been a solid effort trying to get back on the new bike. Insurance companies, and of course no names, no court martials. Insurance companies are a struggle to deal with. There was very little communication. The customer service side of things, the people I spoke to at customer service at my insurance company were really good to deal with, but they couldn't, you know, you can't ring into the total loss department, you can't ring into claims, you've got to wait for them to call you. And that kind of annoyed me a fair bit because I couldn't get an answer. You know, the Africa Twin was solidly written off, and you know, and that's just how it was. But they had it written off for 2 weeks before they even got an answer to me. And I was really not happy with that at all. So yeah, it was a debacle. It certainly mucked around with the old mental health side. I'm still not sleeping as well as I'd like to be at the moment after the accident. Anyone that's had an accident, you know that you react to it very differently after the effect, or after the event. So yeah, look, it was bit of an episode, but now with the bike, I actually slept okay last night. Look, Well, that was interesting. The back wheel locked up. What the hell? Huh. So, let's see how this goes. Wonder how heavy she is. Huh. Oh yeah, a couple of scratches here and there. All right. Here he goes. Back wheel locked up, couldn't unlock it.
Is it locked up?
Yeah. Would not unlock.
That is fucking super skid mark.
Yeah. I reckon it might be me panicking. I'm freaking out a whole heap. And I'm not happy. I reckon it's me. I reckon I've kept my foot on the brake. I'll take full ownership of that. I reckon that's what I've done. And I just panicked. This is what happens. You go for a ride after an accident. You've got to be a little bit more on the money. It's all me, mate. It's all me. I know what the problem is. It's an operator error. I reckon I've just panicked and kept my foot on it.
That you have. Yep. They are very touchy, mate.
Yeah, I reckon I have. And then what it's done, I've just like I've skidded, just lost it, you've and just went in the dirt and had a bit of a roll and a lay down. Yeah. Anything on the helmet?
No, mate, just the noggin that's in it.
Mate, operator error, you got to own it, you got to take ownership. That's on me, so that's...
No, you're probably still in, like, freak out.
I am, mate. Without a doubt, the kind of thing that was... I smell fuel. The kind of thing I'm thinking about is it's like, yeah, I'm, you know, that's... I'm still quite... That's why I said before, I just want to go real easy, and I'm mucking around a bit and then just taking a bit too far.
Maybe we should just take it down to kindergarten school for a bit, mate.
Oh, that's a bit harsh. That's a bit harsh.
Nah, you're right.
you got a Kleenex there for me?
Nah, you're right, mate.
All right, we'll just...
I'd imagine you've been a bit nervous.
Oh, I am. Like, it's a horrible feeling. We might see when...
I hardly ever take the mickey out of you. This is it.
This is my one time option. We'll see if we can get up to workshop. There'll be one up the road.
Yeah,
we'll... And we'll just see if we can... It's just that. All right. Shall we try that again? Ooh. So different mode, off-road mode at the moment. Yep, operator error, that's what it was. can't believe I forgot the SD card for the drone. Talk about having a day far out. Oh, Jesus Christ. Getting off these roads. Holy shit. That's where the trucks are coming from, see? So we should be right through here.
What did it do?
The remote turned off. It's got a purple fucking light.
Give me a look.
And the drone's there. I can't get the cunt back.
All right, we better go get it then.
I can't.
Let me just move this. I'll go get it. Helmet off and we'll go get it.
What happened?
Fuck. Mate, today can go suck a dick. I'm sorry, but today's fucking...
Go to home position. Three stops, come down to that position there. I'm pulling to grab it.
Let's get, you know something, I think we'll just go to the pub.
Hey?
I think we'll just go to the pub. This is fucked. This is fucked. Someone's going to die today. I think it's time to go.
This is
going to
die, but I don't get it. It'll probably just land on the...
Oh, wow. All right, so let's just roll through it. I dropped my Action 4 on the way to the petrol station to see, to catch up with... Mark, I think he had drone issues after that. Then I dropped the bike. After I dropped the bike, I didn't have an SD card for my drone, so that gave me like 30 seconds of airtime. Then Mark's drone just decides to disconnect. Well, he reckons he might have pushed a button. Fair call. Oh, and we've come across some big trucks on very small roads. So, things don't happen in threes, they just happen all the time. All right. Let's just get out of here. Jesus, they're hooting through here. Look at the speed.